After building up all the site fundamentals to make your brand shine, we still need to optimize spacing, create animations, or add borders, shadows, and background when necessary. My name is Lisa, and welcome to Learn with GemPages. In today's video, I'm going to introduce GemPages Design Tab, which will get your store design to its full potential. You can use the timestamps listed to go back and forth on this video. Let's dive right in. Visibility. Visibility allows you to decide whether the element appears or hides on different devices. Take this hero banner, for example. By default, it will be visible to all four views: desktop, laptop, tablet, and mobile. However, I'd like to show it only on the desktop and laptop. By flipping the toggles off, you can see the hero banner has disappeared on the tablet and mobile views. Whenever you see this computer icon, this means you can adjust the element slightly differently in different views. A video dedicated to responsive web design will be coming out soon, so keep a lookout for it. Spacing. Before we go into details of spacing with margin and padding, we need to understand, what is a box model in CSS coding? The box model is essentially a box that wraps around every element, which consists of margins, borders, paddings, and the actual content. The actual content of the element is where text and image appear. Padding is the transparent space between an element's border and content, a border that goes around the padding and content. Finally, the margin is the transparent space around the element's border. Take this row element, for instance. You can tell the difference when we change the padding and margin values. The margin property controls the space outside an element, and the padding property controls the space inside an element. More importantly, the structure and position element content will be changed greatly differently after we adjust padding or margin. Background. There's no denying that background is important. The background you choose can drastically improve your design and make your graphics feel complete. Colors can be used as overlays to enhance brand awareness amongst your audience. While images can be more than just an element, they make for stunning backgrounds when placed appropriately. Feel free to experiment with colors and images, applying blur and transparency. Choosing a background is an imperative part of the conceptual process before going for the one that suits best for your site. Border. From framing your content, placing emphasis, to creating a unique text box, borders are a simple tool that can be used to make your elements stand out. While border style lets you add textures with solid line, dashed line, dotted line, the size and color can be easily changed, making them a versatile tool for many of your design needs. Shadows. Shadow can add qualities like depth, dimension, and visual interest to your designs. This can simultaneously draw viewers into your design and make it seem to pop off the page or screen. On GemPages, it's so easy to turn your imagination into reality, as we can effortlessly customize it with showdown style, shadow angle, shadow distance, you name it. But it's easy to get carried away, so make sure any effect you're using has a specific and practical purpose and makes sense for your project. Then, take a less-is-more approach to applying it to your design. Opacity. For a subtle look, opacity and transparency settings are your best friend when applying effects. It's good practice to start off with an understated application, and then build it up slightly as needed. This will make it less likely that you'll accidentally overdo it. If you don't know where to begin, you can start by researching competitors and brands as the source of inspiration and subtle options that tone with your brand. Position. The position is an advanced setting, and its application is well known for creating the sticky add to cart, which has been covered in another video. Make sure to check it out for the complete know-how. Flow action. With a few clicks away and no extra effort, you've created animated visuals for your brand. Each animation style gives your graphic a distinct look, so you can choose the one that best complements the message in your design. Now we're going to put it into practice by making the button flips up and down when the mouse enters the image on the right. We need to choose the device input event, then the target element, and the last one is the animation. Here is what it looks like in action. Easy peasy, right? Animation. Animation is a simpler version of flow action when we just need to target the action directly to the main element. Now, it's never been easier to grab attention by adding movements like bounce, slide, fade, block, the list goes on. That's all for today. If you find this video helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to hit subscribe as well as the notification bell so that you won't miss out on any future videos. Also, let us know what you want to see next in the comments section below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.